Now let us see the second problem. Compute the endpoint DFT of the signal which is given by x of n is equal to delta of n minus n naught. Okay, where n naught varies from 0 to n. So now we know the DFT of the sequence is given by x of k is equal to summation n is equal to 0, n minus 1, x of n, wn to the power of kn. Okay, so now let me substitute x of n is equal to delta of n minus n naught. So which is equal to summation n is equal to 0, n minus 1, delta of n minus n naught, wn to the power of kn. Okay, so now as we have seen in the previous problem, that is delta of n, that is the function of delta of n, which is equal to 1 when n is equal to 0. Okay, and delta of n is equal to 0, delta of n is equal to 0 when n not equal to 0. So now in the same way, delta of n minus n naught will be 1 when n minus n naught is equal to 0 or when n is equal to n naught. Okay, so in that way, delta of n minus n naught will be equal to 1 when n is equal to n naught, and delta of n minus n naught will be equal to 0 when n not equal to n naught. Okay, so now in the same way, when I expand, I'll be getting only this value, rest all will be 0. So for that purpose, I'll be writing it as delta of n minus n naught will be equal to 1 wn to the power of k n naught, because when n is equal to n naught, it is equal to 1. So what I'll be getting, w n into k into n naught. Okay, so what is w n? Either I can keep it in this way, or else I can also keep it as, what is w n? It is nothing but e to the power of minus j 2 pi by n. Okay, so I'll be writing w n, that is e to the power of minus j 2 pi by n into k into n naught, that is your x of k.